Hi guys, this is Dane Dormio again with Chai Chi Tai Chi and Martial Energetics. And today I wanted to take a few minutes to talk with you about the three regulations and specifically mind regulation. In the previous video we started talking about the foundations of Qigong, starting with the non-exertion principle, which says don't try too hard. And the foundation of Qigong also consists of three regulations. The three regulations define Qigong. The three regulations are body regulation, breath regulation, and mind regulation. And I'm starting today talking about mind regulation. I normally like to introduce mind regulation first, because mind regulation is really what provides the basis for body regulation and breath regulation. Mind regulation essentially means paying attention to what's on your mind. It is sort of synonymous with meditation. When we're practicing Qigong, it's not just about the physical movements, and it's also not just about the breathing, it's also about what we're doing mentally with our mental focus. So mind regulation consists of all aspects of mental processes associated with doing Qigong. Mind regulation includes emotions, thoughts, perceptions, and all of these kinds of things. So you could think of mind regulation as just meditation, and there are lots of different types of meditation. There are very specific meditation techniques. All of them would be forms of mind regulation, and if you are familiar with different types of meditation techniques, then you can certainly experiment with incorporating those into your Qigong practice. But the most basic and fundamental type of mind regulation is just pure awareness, or what's often referred to as mindfulness. Just being mindful while you're engaging in your practice of everything that you're thinking, feeling, perceiving, sensing. This is the technique used in Vipassana meditation, where there's absolutely no aim or goal whatsoever other than just pure awareness. And this is the sort of basic or default type of mind regulation for Qigong practice, that you're just allowing pure awareness to exist, and you are noticing things that arise in it. You notice bodily sensations in particular, focusing on feeling the body, experiencing the body, is very important for Qigong. There are also thoughts that arise in the mind, that arise within awareness, and practicing mindfulness is what allows us to not identify with the thoughts, but rather to observe them. So you have the thought, but you are not the thought, and you're aware of your consciousness in which the thought exists. So thoughts are sort of spontaneous. They come and go. One image I like to use is when you're lying on your back on a nice summer day looking up at the sky, and there are these clouds floating by, and you see the clouds floating by, but you stay where you are. You're still lying on the ground just looking up at the sky, and you see the clouds come and go, and they morph and they shift as you observe them, but you don't identify with them. You don't think of yourself as the cloud. Another image I like to use for thoughts is that you're in a train station, and the trains pull in and they pause for a moment and they pull out, and all the time trains are coming and going, much like thoughts. But you don't get on the train, you sit on the bench and you just observe the coming and going of the trains, but you're not getting on any of them. You're not getting sidetracked or hijacked by a particular train of thought that you're getting on and following. You just observe the thoughts coming and going, but you don't get on board. So whatever else is going on in your Qigong practice, mind regulation has to be going on, otherwise it's not Qigong. The three regulations define Qigong, so whatever you're doing, if you're engaging mind regulation, body regulation, and breath regulation, then it's a form of Qigong. And if you're not doing all three of those things, then it's not Qigong, even if you're going through the motions and doing the patterns and whatnot. It's not really Qigong without all three regulations, including mind regulation. One huge advantage of Qigong is that it's a meditation practice that you don't have to sit still for. A lot of people find when they try traditional meditation that involves sitting, they find one of the most challenging things about it is actually sitting still to meditate. And the great thing about Qigong is you don't have to sit still. You certainly can. You can sit and engage the three regulations if you want. But Qigong is best experienced at least standing. You could be standing, not moving. You could be standing, moving. You could be doing simple repetitive movements, or you could be doing more involved spontaneous types of movements where you're moving around, maybe interacting with things in the room. So Qigong allows us to have the opportunity to meditate and also engage the body at the same time, take care of the body's needs, also focus on breath regulation so that we're focusing on meeting all of the body's needs, and it actually makes it much easier to concentrate on pure awareness and engage mind regulation that way. So I hope that this is useful for you. I hope it's some information you can incorporate into your Qigong practice or even some other practice like yoga, and hopefully you can incorporate it into your everyday life, because that's really what this stuff is all about. If you have any questions or comments or feedback for me, I'd love to hear them in the comments. If there's something else you'd like to hear me talk about, please let me know. And stay tuned. I'll be releasing more of these videos over the coming weeks about Qigong and how it can improve your life. So thanks a lot, and I look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye, guys.